What would the Rockefellers do? How the wealthy get and stay that way, and how you can too. Narrated by the authors, Garrett Gunderson, that's me, and Michael Isom. What would the Rockefellers do? How the wealthy get and stay that way, and how you can too. I'm so glad you made this investment. I look forward to this time together. See, the original version of the book, What Would the Rockefellers Do?, was actually published in 2016. It's now in the hands of hundreds of thousands of people with thousands of amazing reviews on Amazon. I didn't even know. I started looking at them in October of 2022 and was like, this is amazing. It's so phenomenal. So now we're called to complete another version for you. Why an updated version? Well, the core message hasn't changed at all, but the economy has. The banking landscape has changed, and it's even riskier than it was when we wrote the original version of the book. And with all the pandemic-related changes, like hikes in interest rates and a massive amount of inflation, and then there's been the launch of new technologies and fear around AI, some of these areas really deserve more expansion and support of your legacy journey. Michael and I want to provide more insight into and resources for the process of investing in your heirs, hosting family retreats, and capturing the critical philosophies, values, and culture of your family. These are all things you can start to do right away today by downloading your bonus. It's a course, and that course is the Legacy Toolkit at rockefellersbook.com/legacy. So I'll be the narrator of most of the book. However, Michael is going to add stories, insights, and resources in special sections throughout. See, the thing about it is, he's the guy that knows the numbers and the details. I'm the one that looks a little bit like Jesus, and people are always like, oh, what would Garrett do? And I'm like, well, what would the Rockefellers do? That's how the kind of frame of this book even came up. So you'll want to go to the website because we've added new illustrations and we want to share the math behind the centerpiece of the Rockefeller method. Properly structured, optimally funded whole life insurance combined with trusts. So we published this updated version because there's a lot of misinformation and product salesmen that were touting products and strategies that actually create risk and were unlikely to work. We want to clearly point those out to you. And just because there's a product illustrated with higher numbers doesn't mean that that really takes risk into consideration. So I've added this chapter called The Economic Value of Certainty. It's so critical in the mindset and framework of creating sustainable wealth and protecting and perpetuating your legacy. The methods we're going to teach in this, they don't rely on luck or risk. You don't have to chase returns or even start with millions of dollars. There's a specific methodology and tools that are crucial to predictable results. I want to give a little special shout out to all the financial professionals who've been buying this book in quantities and sharing them with people to help promote legacy and financial stability for their families and clients. Just so grateful for you. And finally, a shout out to you, the listener. I commend you for investing in yourself, for being bold and courageous enough to say you even want to create a legacy. I applaud you and support your quest to live a life that you love, that life of prosperity, where you can focus on what matters most and build the legacy you envision. Download the Legacy Builders course. The Legacy Builders course is a detailed 43-page workbook with videos. This course details three critical and distinct phases to support you in the building of your legacy and implementing everything you've learned in this book and even a little more. The workbook is broken up into the following three phases of legacy planning. Phase one, how to initiate a lasting family legacy. In this section, we guide you to create your family trust, show you how to involve your children in building a legacy while ensuring their long-term productivity and success, how to keep the money together by initiating the Rockefeller method and setting up your financial structures properly, and how to start paying yourself first automatically, even tax strategies on how to pay your kids, including ideas of the different things you can have them do for work. Phase two, the family constitution. In this section, I'll give you instructions on how to create a family constitution that prevents your heirs from getting spoiled, and it actually protects your legacy against such a possibility. It helps you to clearly define your family legacy so you have a clear vision of what you're building, and how to select the board of trustees for your family trust. And if you listen to that part of the book, you don't have to be wealthy to have a board of trustees, just people that you know and trust that say, if I'm not around, who would I want my kids to learn from? And that would edify certain aspects of my life. And it might not just be one individual that could do all of that. So that's why it might be three, four, or five people. All right, phase three, family meetings and retreats. This section gives you detailed support in learning how to set up family meetings to be as productive and beneficial as possible. how to establish family values, rules, traditions, rituals, habits, and goals. That's a mouthful right there. But it doesn't matter where you're at, blended family, just starting a family, kids, no kids, you can start this at any time. Don't feel bad if it's been a while and you're like, oh, I wish I would have known this earlier. You know it now. Most families have never even had this insight. Then we show you how to create your family crest, a mantra, and a family creed, and finally teach your kids about money. So download your Legacy Builders course for free now at rockefellersbook.com/legacy. You'll be glad you did. Friday, June 9th, 2006, about 6 a.m., my landline rings. Now, first I'm confused. I don't answer. But the ringing persists. What? I belt into the phone. I hear the voice of my business partner, Michael Isom. Slowly, shakily, he says, the company plane left after our event last night and nobody's heard from Ray or Les. What? I mean, how? There has to be some explanation. Ray and Les are our business partners and more than that, our friends. I turn on the TV to breaking news. A plane had crashed into Utah Lake near the small airport where Ray and Les were supposed to have landed last night. I'm in shock. I mean, my brain doesn't want to accept it. At the company retreat, just a month before, our firm had come up with the idea to work together to write a book. We were excited to get started. The idea was fueled by hearing over and over again at our events, I wish I would have heard this sooner. Or, how do I share this information with my parents or my friends or my kids? With the unexpected and devastating deaths of our partners and the lessons we still had to learn, it wasn't yet time for this book to be written. I hadn't met Sheila Brandenburg, a CPA for the Rockefeller Global Family Office. We hadn't yet seen the risk to our partners' legacies after their deaths. I mean, it was surprising and alarming to witness people approaching their widows with these ideas on how they should use this wealth or their life insurance proceeds. I mean, people would request meetings to pitch business ideas. They'd ask for real estate funding. The list goes on. Look, these widows, they couldn't afford to chase some risky opportunity. Thank God there were structures and rules with trusts that protected and preserved the wealth. In 2015, Michael and I were in Las Vegas between Christmas and New Year's Eve, and we're preparing for the next year. What Would the Rockefellers Do was born during our conversations that week, and the original version was published a decade after the plane crash. By that time, with the death of our partners, the deaths of some of our clients, and the risk to their families and legacies, we had this firsthand experience of what we cover in this book. Now, as financial advisors, Michael and I have worked with thousands of people in different phases of their lives. It's given us a unique perspective. We've also had access to an amazing research team and attorneys as we explore what works and is most critical for preserving and perpetuating wealth. This book has been designed over decades of deep discussion, hosting workshops, and bringing the concepts to life for our clients. Look, Michael's instrumental in sharing our message, both on stage around the United States and through one-on-one work with countless clients. He delivers masterful speeches with emotion and engagement, inspiring audiences to live and leave a legacy. It's one thing to listen about this, right, like on an audiobook, but totally another thing to experience it. So if you host events or know someone who does, I highly recommend that you get in touch with us at rockefellersbook.com/speaking and book Michael. Michael also wrote a fantastic book called What We're Worth, Realizing Your Human Life Value, and Know What You're Really Worth. I endorse it. I highly recommend it. It's a perfect companion to this book. It's both easy to read and highly impactful. You can check it out at vaultais.com/worth. Michael and I have known each other for almost a quarter of a century now. We met way back in 1999 when I was still in college. Michael had just started in financial services at Guardian Life. We had this relentless curiosity about personal finance, and we studied it together at this small dining room table in this townhome that I had as my college place, right? That curiosity was and still is one of our key advantages.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.